Hello guys, as I promised in other videos, here is the full multimedia system review on the new Skoda Octavia, for example, right now. But this is the new Skoda multimedia system MIB3, and also the new cockpit, digital cockpit. And I want to go into detail a little bit, and I want to show you all the different functions and different information. So for example, right now on this Octavia, we have those controllers right here on the steering wheel. So you have those buttons that you can control different functions right there on the cockpit. Also, Skoda really changed the design of those buttons, and they look really, really good these days. Also on the other side, you have the controllers right here. You have also different function where you can control the music, for example, and the volume from here. You can adjust it, and you can change different radio functions. And then you have the speaker. Skoda also add this Laura speaker, so you can,
what would you like to
yes, Laura, so you have to say only Laura, and then you will hear that voice command. So it's quite interesting that you can speak with your car, for example. I'm not a big fan of this talking with the car. Let me try again. Hello, Laura. Hey, Laura.
How can I help?
Navigate to Paris. And it's loading right now. Let's see. Navigate to Paris.
Please wait a moment.
All right. We wait. Okay, it's loading.
To start voice control again, please press the push to talk button.
Oh, come on. Navigate to Paris. Let's see if the navigation works.
Please wait.
Okay, come on. You can see it's probably try to connect.
Wait.
To connect to the internet, stuff like that. I don't have too much time to wait. By the way, in this time,
please wait.
Oh, okay.
Please repeat.
Navigate to Paris. Anyway, let's go forward. I'm not a big fan of this speaking stuff. Now, guys, check it out. There in the front, you have the head-up display that it's directly on the windscreen. I think you can see it. Let me try again to focus on it. I don't think the camera doesn't want to focus on it. Maybe try again right now. Yeah, almost. Anyway, the head-up display, it's pretty cool, and also the navigation system, it's work really, really good. You can see it right now on the screen right there. Also, you have a very good visibility on the camera. You cannot see it so well, but it's work really good. So the car come also with this speaking control. Laura, this is new here. I'm not a big fan of this speaking stuff, press and speak, and I think the system, it should be upgraded not only on the Skoda cars and on this MIB3 system, but also on every system. Now, the navigation and the cockpit. Here on the right side, you have these buttons, and you can change different functions right there. For example, here you can zoom in and zoom out. You can change from those buttons. Also, you can see the screen like this, only the speed. This is the sport mode. For example, you can see it in the sport mode, and you can change, for example, to see the dials, classic dials, and you have different function there. Here it's also the adaptive cruise control, emergency brake, and all that safety features. You can see it right there, and this is my favorite screen, the navigation one. The visibility from the driver point of view, it's really, really good. You have a great visibility even on the multimedia system and even on the cockpit. So from this point of view, you can't complain about that. Also here, it's a huge screen. I think it's 12 inch display. It's really big, and you have such a good visibility right here on the multimedia system. Also the colors and the brightness on the both screens, it is really, really good. And here you have some physical button where you can go in different functions. For example, if you set this, press the set, you have the start stop engine button. You can activate, deactivate pressure, tires here, driving assist. You go to driving assist. Let me go back. You go to driving assist right now, and you can see right here you have all the functions for the safety feature. For example, lane assist, blind spot, reading the traffic speed limit, cruise control, emergency brake, and all that safety feature. You can see it also has a list, so it's quite cool. You can activate and deactivate it from here. This is very nice graphic, it's super nice. Then you have the driving modes right here. You can go in different modes: eco, comfort, normal, sport mode, individual. Every time you change a driving mode, the driving experience will change, because when you go in eco, the car will change the gears really earlier, so it doesn't wait too much to change the gear. Also, the steering wheel is a little bit stiffer. When you go in comfort, the car will change the gear between earlier and later, so we can give you the best comfort, and also the steering wheel will be much more easy to maneuver. And the suspension, because the car come with DCC chassis control, and this is really amazing. The suspension will be really comfortable. If you go in sport or normal sport mode, the car will try to give you the best experience, the maximum speed. Also, it will change the gear later. The steering will be really stiffer, and the suspension will be really stiff and down to the ground, and you will feel like you're stick to the ground. It's really awesome. And the normal mode is just normal, a combination of this, all of this between there. So that's as an information. Then you have the assist button here that gets you directly to the parking assist. Here you have the parking camera, so in the parking camera you can have a trailer information. You can see the blind spot there. The car come also with this safety feature that when you go in reverse, it will tell you if a car come, and it will also automatic brake. Now also the car come, if you go to assist, it will come with park assist, and it will help you to park. So this is really, really great feature. I use it a very long time on my cars, but now I'm not using it, but it's really safe to be there. It's good to be there. Climatic system here, it gets you directly to the climatic system. This is awesome. You have this physical button, and you can go here, turn on the climatic system like that, and you have these new graphics. It's very cool. I think someone worked a lot of these graphics, because you have the frost windows, warm my feet, warm hands, cool my feet, fresh air, give you fresh air. It's extra clean the air inside the cabin, so I think this is also super awesome to have those options. You have the classic, this is the smart AC, so all you have to do is just press one of these and then it will work great. You have the rear, also in the back you have the possibility, because this is free climatic, free zone climatic system, so in the back you have also for the passengers. And then here you just press the button and the car will do what it say there. Warm my hands, it will turn on the heating on the steering wheel, and also, yeah, depend what you like, the frost windows. Classic AC here, it gets you to the glassy one. You can control it automatic, you can put it on auto, or you can put it on manual the way you want it. And air care is this great system that Skoda come with a few years ago, and it fresh up the air a little bit more, so that's awesome. Heated seats for the passengers, by the way. Here are the button, and here are the controllers for the climatic system while you are in the climatic system, so just something to keep in mind. Now then you have the maximum and the rear defrosting. This, those buttons are awesome that they make physical button. It's great, you just press it, and many times in the winter time, for example, now check out the windows, they are frosting, and then you just press the button to the maximum, and in a few seconds you can see how it's work really good and really fast. I think in 1 minute maximum you will have all the windows defrosted, and that's work really, really good. In my opinion, this is awesome that you have this physical button. You don't have to go, you press it one more time and it will close. You don't have to go in every settings here in the multimedia system. Also, multimedia system screen, it's a glossy screen, it's super, super responsive. I like it very much how responsive it is. Also, you have here on the side the home button that gets you to the home. Here's the home button, you can customize the way you want it. You have the navigation, you have the vehicle information, radio, telephone connection. You can go on the right side, you have the information about the trip, you can connect your phone, you have all the information here, the contacts and stuff. and you can see the trip and the consumption in the last kilometers. Then you have, for example, here settings, get you directly to the settings, mobile device, restore to the factory and stuff like that. Then going to home, guys, here again, if you go to vehicle, you can see information about the exterior. For exterior, you have the mirrors. You can adjust the way you want it to lower in reverse gear. When you go in reverse, it will lower, it will dim down to help you park a little bit better. Then fold in when locking, and you have a few settings here, wipe automatic in rain, automatic rear wipers and stuff like that. This is great, those wipers and mirrors. Then you have the comfort light here, coming home and change different settings on the comfort light, headlights here, dynamic light assist, dynamic cornering light, switch on time, automatic headwind control in rain, convenient turn signals and travel mode. Super cool, huh? And then you have the tires here, the tire pressure and warning and stuff like that. Interesting. Exterior, interior, you go in the interior, setting of the car in the interior. You have here the head-up display, as you see it before, you can turn it on and off. I don't know why my camera never want to focus on this head-up display. It's really good one. It looks really great in real, but on the camera, yeah. Here you can activate, you can put it down, up, down, left, right, driving assist. Also, you can choose what you like to see there, the navigation, the road, traffic, and it's good. It's really good. And also here you have different settings, data about the car. So for example, you can check this out, vehicle. And yeah, going back to the exterior, wait a minute, I'll show you later this, to the interior, sorry. Then instrument cluster here, you can choose different stuff, echo tips and stuff like that. And then interior light, by the way, on the light here, you have some light brightness, you can adjust it from here. Then you have the status of the car and the data that you see it before. Now going back to the menu, we are finished with home, we go in the menu. Here you have the phone connectivity, the radio, the navigation. It's working really good, the navigation, it's one of the best. It looks great. You can have different, this is the newest navigation system from Volkswagen Group, and it works really good. It has a little bit of lag, but not so much. But once you're setting up the navigation, it's great. It's also connected to the internet, so you have internet connectivity, so you can see the traffic and all the information. So in terms of quality, it's very good. It's very good. Going forward, menu, going to the vehicle, you already see all that information about the vehicle. Then the background light, here is the interior light. Here you can change the light the way you want, the mood light. When you change the mood light, winter mood, you can see it's changed the color. And also it's changed the color on the digital display. You can see it's a blue color, and also here is the same color in the background. If you change it, it go to yellow, and also there it's go to yellow. Focus. Yes. Anyway, it's super cool. And if you go to individual, you can change yourself the green, the way you want to see it on the cockpit there. You can see the colors, you can make it in every color you want. And also here, color 2, you can change it as well. And that's super, super nice. Brightness here, you can choose the brightness. You can see in the interior, you have ambient light also on the doors. Let me turn on the light right now. I think you can see the light right now. It's green here. And also here under the dashboard, it's quite nice, the ambient light inside the car. Then going to menu, going to manual, smart link here, you can connect your Android, Apple car phone. This is also a great feature. Going forward, you have user assistance systems, you already see it. You can and then sound, it has a great sound here. And then you can change different types here. It comes with Canton speakers, great speakers, and you can choose here different function, and you can adjust it the way you want it. So it's really
voice
good
control volume.
It's really good. Anyway, and then you have another page where you have the settings, and then here you have data connect, mobile phone, have units, you can change it in miles, kilometer, distance and stuff like that. Also you can change the language, in which language you want to see the car, time and date and stuff like that. So overall, this is the multimedia system. I hope you make an idea about it. This is the cockpit. You see before that you can change the different functions from here. Super easy. The visibility, it's quite good from the driver point of view. I like it very much. This is the sport mode. Also the car, it's just phenomenal. And yeah, it's super, super complex. I like it very much. I will try one more time this LoRa, also the head-up display. I think you already see it.
What can I do for you?
Yes, he hear me. Navigate to a restaurant. Let's see if it's work.
Please say the full address, starting with the city.
All right, Paris.
Sorry, spelling is not supported.
All right. Anyway, yeah, let me try again. LoRa. Hey, LoRa.
What can I do for you?
Turn off the climatic system.
Cancel.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's still working. Yeah. Anyway, guys, I guess that was my review with the multimedia system of the new Skoda multimedia system MIB3. This is the latest one. It's amazing. I love it. I think everything, it's worked perfectly. I'm not a big fan of this LoRa speaking, or not only on the Skoda cars, but overall. So even on my Tesla or even on other cars, whatever car it is, I never use this speak command. And overall, other than that, I think it's working really, really good. It's a great system, and I think it's one of the best on the market. And at this price, Skoda have amazing price. The cars from Skoda offer a lot of things at the lowest price, and I think
How can I help?
They are amazing. You can help by shutting up, because I want to finish my review. Thank you. Anyway, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out my other videos and see you soon. Bye, LoRa.